Sup, Trophy Hunters, King Superhorns just signed in, and welcome to the May edition of the Flash Sale, sponsored by Games Yet to Platinum. So, let's get this started right now. The crew, the game and DLC, yeah, is worth getting. And Alienation, highly recommended. Dragon Age, Resident Evil 4, and Resident Evil 6 are all worth buying, so get it while you can. And Titanfall 2 and Jak and Daxter bundle? Well, looks like I'm going to be buying them myself. Resident Evil 5, Detonation, Devil May Cry 4, and Firewatch, they're all worth buying right now. Especially Firewatch, which is exactly what I'm going to get. Helldivers and Journey? Yes. Mirror's Edge Catalyst? I mean, that's up to you. Mirror's Soul Suspect is better to do the GameStop pre-owned method. Need for Speed and Plants vs. Zombies 2 is all online, so it depends on you if you really want to get them or not, but I'll get Plants vs. Zombies 2. Sticks has to be cheaper for me to get. The Jackbox Party depends if you really want to get it or not. You know, Arizona Sunshine, if the game's even fucking cheaper, I'll fucking get it. But it's always going to be the same fucking price. But Beast Buggy Racing and Cat Lateral Damage, yeah, definitely worth getting. Medieval Warfare, it depends on you. But the Dead Rising Triple Pack, I mean, it's worth getting unless you really want a very time-consuming platinum. Dust EX Mankind Divided, yeah, it's worth getting, but this DLC trap. Energy Invasion, oh yeah, definitely, yes. Escape Plan, I mean, if you really have the balls to actually try to 100% the game. Euro Fishing, well, the season pass is on sale, but I'm not interested in that, so that's your choice or not. Everybody's Gone to Rasher, yes. Fat Princess Adventures, yes. Firewatch, I mean, come on. Game of Thrones, yes, definitely worth getting. Gunjack, that depends on you. The Jak and Daxters, I mean, come on, there's the bundle already on sale. And Journey, obviously, yes. King's Quest, it kind of depends if you want to get it or not. It's very time-consuming, a lot of fucking missable trophies, but that's your choice if you want easy 100%. Laura Croft, yes, definitely worth getting. Loco Roco, definitely worth getting for both of them. If Loco Roco 2 was cheaper, I'll probably get it. Mafia 3 is a DLC trap. Marooners looks like a rip-off Mario Party, so I'm definitely going to get that. Matterfall, dude, anything by Housemarque is definitely worth my fucking books. So yes, Matterfall is definitely worth getting. MotoGP 17 has to be cheaper. Has to be. MXGP 3, no, I'm not getting that. Need for Speed, obviously, I already talked about that. Need for Speed Rivals, yeah, it's worth getting. It's only like, what, 2 online trophies, so it's not even that bad. Next, Machina, definitely worth getting. Our World, yes. Party Golf, I mean, if you want frustrations in your life, depends if you want to get it or not. I don't know, I'm not getting that shit. It has a platinum, though. Peggle 2, yes, definitely worth getting. Plants vs. Zombies, yes. Resident Evil, we'll skip on that for now. Well, speaking of skipping Resident Evil, the Deluxe Origin Bundle, yes, definitely worth getting. Revelations 2, well, we'll skip that for now. Ride 2 has to be cheaper for me to get it. Rogue Legacy, yes. Slender, I mean, that's your choice if you want to get it. I'm good with Outlast. Soma, definitely worth getting. Star Wars Battlefront, yes, definitely worth getting. Has all the DLCs and everything. Thief, oh, for $3, yeah. For the Trine series, yeah, you better fucking get it. Shit, that's definitely worth getting. Virtual Reality Football Club, I mean, that depends on you. I don't know what the fuck that is. I don't give no fucks. Among the Sleep, if it was cheaper, yes, I'll get it. Battlefield 4, yes, definitely worth getting, plus the DLC and everything. Battlefield Hardline, I mean, if you really have the balls to 100% the DLC, that's your choice. But, yeah, I don't know if I really want to say yes to that game, really. Bound, yes, definitely worth getting. So CounterSpy will have one unattainable trophy by the end of the month. So make sure you're at least 100% the game before the end of the month, or else it's going to be like one trophy that's unattainable. So make sure you guys get CounterSpy. If you guys have the game, make sure you get it. But if no one has it right now, it's definitely worth buying right now, at least for the next 2 weeks. So if anyone is looking forward to 100% CounterSpy, y'all better do that shit now. As for Dick Wild, Need for Speed, the EA Family Bundle, depends if you want to get it. Need for Speed and Plants vs. Zombies both online. Unravel isn't really online, it's easy. They're all, I guess they're all easy. Platinums, not really. Maybe Plants vs. Zombies and Need for Speed, not really. Unrivaled, yes, but it depends. It's $10, why not? E-Magnus 2, I would get it, but it has to be cheaper. Far Cry Primal, hell no. Fuck no. Guilty Gear, nah, not really. Has to be cheaper. Here They Lie, nope, has to be cheaper. Inside, same thing, has to be cheaper. Life is Strange, yes, definitely worth getting. Limbo, I mean, obviously, the game is really good. But if you want to get Limbo and Inside bundle, it's probably worth getting that instead. But I'd rather get Inside cheaper. I already have Limbo, so it's fine. Monster Jam, yeah, definitely worth getting. NBA 2K18, yeah. That's your choice. Some Pyrehead Arcade, it has a platinum. The problem is, it's very, very, very frustrating. So that's your choice if you want to get the game or not. Rayman Legends, I mean, come on, man. It's free on Plus right now. If you actually fucking purchase the game on the flash sale, you are the most retarded motherfucker on the fucking planet. If you have PlayStation Plus, you can get it free right there. It says right there, free. Like, come on. As for Resident Evil Revelations 1 and 2, the bundle, yes, that's definitely worth getting. Skullgirls 2nd Encore, yes, definitely worth getting. Super Meat Boy, it depends if you have the balls to actually try to platinum the game. Tomb Raider, yeah, it's definitely worth getting, but I'm pretty sure it was free on Plus. No, it was free on Plus on PS3, my bad, sorry. But Tomb Raider, yes, definitely worth getting. Unraveled, obviously, yes. Valkyria Chronicles, oh man, I would say yes, but I'd rather get it if it's cheaper. It's definitely worth getting, but I want to get it when it's cheap. Verdun, yeah. I'm not buying that shit. It's online only. Fuck that shit. Watch Dogs is DLC trap. Alright, PS3 section time. Need for Speed Most Wanted has DLC trap, but Need for Speed Rival is definitely worth getting. Battlefield 4 Premium Edition, yes, definitely worth getting. Dead Space 2, yes. Jak and Daxter Collection, oh, yeah. $3.99, yeah, definitely worth getting. Need for Speed Hot Pursuit, that has DLC trap also. Sleeping Dogs is definitely worth getting, but it has DLC trap. Alice Man's Returns, once again, DLC trap. Battlefield 3, yes, but DLC trap again. Bioshock Infinite, definitely worth getting. And the Season Pass, oh, yeah, he's right there, so you might as well get them both. And Borderlands, the pre-sequel, yeah, definitely worth. So Borderlands 2 Season Pass, I mean, you can get it, but I'd rather get the Game of the Year edition, which is much better. Chivalry, Medieval Warfare, I mean, it depends on you. CounterSpy, once again, well, first of all, it's stackable, so you can actually get the PS3 and the PS4 if you want to. And also, obviously, it's going to be one unattainable trophy by the end of the month, so if you, anyone who's getting CounterSpy, go ahead and get it, buy it, try to 100% as fast as you can. That's basically it. Dead Space 3, definitely worth getting. Dead Space, yes. Dragon Age 2, yes, but DLC trap. Dragon Age Origins, yes, but it's also DLC trap. Game of Thrones, I mean, just do the GameStop method and then you'll be fine. Helldivers, yes, it's definitely worth getting. King's Quest, like I said, it's your choice if you want to get it or not. Life is Strange, Limbo, Mirror's Edge, and Persona 4, they're all yes, definitely worth getting. Thief and Tomb Raider, yes, definitely worth getting. Looks like there's really nothing else worth getting on the PS3 section, but yeah, that's it. And for the results. So there's two games added to the first survey, and two games added to the second survey, with a total of $54.93. So stay tuned next month for the next flash sale video, as you are listening to the best Trophy Hunter.